today's video, I wanted to show and share with you how I would carry my centerline systems mother carrier and G-roll. And I just kind of wanted to give some thought behind why I packed what I packed, and just my overall idea of this kind of stuff. I think a lot of times I get caught up in survival kits and packing stuff a certain way and carrying certain stuff because I think it's a dire need, it's a necessity, and it's not necessarily survival. And if we're really honest with ourselves, most of us have never and probably will never be in an actual true survival situation. And my idea of a survival situation is one, either like a military kind of thing where enemy fire and maybe you got separated from your team, or just some of the horrible things that have happened to our military members and military vets, and they literally get out of there, you know, just barely alive, and that's actual survival. There's actual survival stories, like outdoor wood survival stories, where like the 127 hours guy that fell down in the canyon and actually had to cut his arm off to get out, to stay alive. I think that a lot of times is what we have in mind that's gonna happen to us. But for the most part, we're coming here into the woods with enough gear and enough kit and foreknowledge that it's likely not gonna happen to us. Also think that goes with the idea of survival is not glamorous and it's not fun. And we should never wish or want that to happen to ourselves or anyone, because in my opinion, it's a thing that if you're ever actually in that scenario, there are no rules anymore. There are no procedures that you follow. There are no guidelines. It's just whatever it takes to get home or to get back to your loved ones or to just make it through the night. But for the people that go in those situations and come out through the other side, they tapped into something inside their, you know, innate selves that allowed them to make it through it. And that's where that mental fortitude and mental strength, I think, comes into play. And I don't know if any of us would ever know if we have that or not until something like that happened. And that's whenever you hope and pray that it never does.
What I have here is my Centerline Systems mother carrier and a Centerline Systems G-roll. And I've got it set up in a way that nothing's tied onto it. There's no knots that are permanent. I can undo both separately and carry just the carrier off on a little scout if I need to, or put it all together. What I'll go over first is the way I have it lashed. So all I have is just some of the heavy duty shock cord from Paracord Planet, and just the cord locks. So both of these knots right here are just like safety knots to keep it from slipping any if it does. And so those are both here in the front, and then the cord locks can come off completely. And there's a reason for that, like my logic behind it, and I'll show you that in a second. And then on the back, to keep it from bouncing around on the back, and to just keep it, make it, give it a better fit, I've got the same thing, just running through the straps of the G-roll and then through the molly webbing of the mother carrier, of how I have this set up. So I have the cord locks in the front running through this loop and then under the G-roll, and they're attached to the webbing on the bottom of the mother carrier, and then the two tag ends I just have running up through this loop with a little safety hitch up here at the top. Then this is what the back looks like. I just have the shorter shock cord running through both the shock cord that goes under the mother carrier and the webbing on the G-roll, and then it cord locked to the molly. Really quick and easy to take it on and off. This is essentially my food, and more importantly, most of my cover elements. So with my mindset of thinking, if I have to rely only on what I'm carrying because I found myself in an injured situation, or I've just somehow gotten lost where I am and I don't know how to get home, and I realize I'm going to have to stay the night. The first thing that I feel like most people are going to fight against, including myself, is panic. And your heart rate's up, and no matter how much training and stuff you have, the adrenaline's going to kick in, and you're going to have to figure out a plan so that you can get home the next day. And it's obviously two completely different situations, an injury or whatever. Let's just say that I'm lost. My idea is, if I'm lost and I'm gonna have to stay the night, then what I have with me should help alleviate some of that panic. There's comfort items in here because I feel like I can get away with carrying them and they don't add too much weight to it. But there's also necessities in here. So I'll just go over what's on the outside. This is one of the large contractor bags, the 3 mil thick ones. This thing's almost as long as my body, and I'm right at 6 feet. That's one of two that I have in this. I've got my Baco Laplander, a set of leather gloves, and then my titanium spoon. Technically, the spork, the gloves, and even the Baco are comfort items, because if I'm carrying what I have in my pockets and my EDC with me, I've got a cutting tool already, which is the knife on my hip. So those are things that don't take up a lot of weight, and they'll just make life easier for me if I'm in some kind of situation. The way that this works is there's just moly webbing sewn on this panel, and they give you X amount of shock cord and cord locks to where you can just configure this however you want. So this is just how I did it. Now in the pocket here, it's Velcro. The first thing that I have up top is what I call my food bag. I know there's going to be a lot of different opinions on this, and that's fine if that's what works for you, it's what works for you. But I'm not planning on bringing a whole bunch of food with me for just a lightweight day hike kit that could get me out of a pinch if needed to. Like I said, this is not a camping kit, so I'm not planning on staying multiple days. So literally what I have in here is more stuff having to do with hydration than food, because for me, hydration is a bigger important task to get done than eating if I'm in a survival situation. So I've got some more comfort stuff in here that'll make life easier if I do have to boil my water and filter and all that stuff. I've got some Propel drink packets, some plain caffeine flavored drink packets, a thing of coffee, and a thing of hot chocolate. That's probably 2, 4, 6, 7. That's 7 mixes and then a coffee and a hot chocolate. And then I also have 2 packets of oatmeal, because just having something in you is better than nothing. And these are just small, and it's what I had, and I think that would be enough for me to at least try to get home the next morning. Eat one at night, eat one for breakfast, and I've at least got some kind of sustenance in me. Next, I have the second contractor bag, and these are very important because of everything you can do with them. You can make a debris pad, you can use it as a bivy, you could use one as a poncho, you could split one down and use it as a ground sheet. I mean, there's tons of uses for this, and I don't think that they get enough credit. So I've got 2 of those with me. And then my main form of shelter is just the grabber space blankets, reflective on one side, orange on the other. And then I just took some of the same shock cord that I used on my mother carrier and put it on all the grommets so that they're less likely to tear out. And if it's high winds or whatever, there's a little bit of give to it. So that's my main form of shelter, overhead shelter. And then I also have one of these I could use as a ground sheet. The other one is a bivy. And then I was also able to squeeze in here this SOL sheet. And I actually got this for Christmas. So I've not used it, but I'm just planning on keeping it in this kit. But it's like their cheap Mylar space blanket that SOL makes. But it's OD green, and it says 2X thickness, so it's their heavier, thickest one that they make, and that's also given me another form of comfort. And like I said,
you're fighting against being stressed and panicked and what am I going to do? I'm out here now. I've got to use what I have in a way to keep me, you know, warm tonight or to keep me dry, whatever the case may be. So this in itself, I can use in correlation with my bungees or with these shock cords and cord locks and use this as a debris mat if I want to, and then use these bags as a debris bag to climb into or whatnot. I can use these things that can wrap around the edges and bundle it up to make, you know, fold it up in a way to make a mattress, just all kinds of things. So I wanted to have some stretch cord and all that with this kit because it's just really functional. So that's everything in the G-Roll. All right, so let's take a look at what's in the mother carrier. Here in the front pocket, like I said in my other video, I try to keep stuff that I can get to really quick and easy because it's really easy to just undo that latch and pull this Velcro pocket up. So I have got another convenient item in here. This is a pocket bolo, and this pairs up with another item that I have with this kit. I'll go over that in a second. So this is just one of those collapsible metal straws that you can basically use to help get a fire going from coals or to help feed a fire a little bit better. And then I have my headlamp. And I always check the batteries before I go out. Normally I keep an extra set with me. I just happen to forget them this time. But I keep the knob over here untwisted so that it can't turn on accident. So that way it will help save my batteries. And then I have some cordage. I have about a 30 foot roll of number 36 bank line and about a 15 or so foot roll of number 18 bank line. And then I have my compass, and it's on a lanyard that has Ranger beads attached to it. Over here in the side pocket, I have some more cordage. This is a really short piece that I actually will use to hang my bag up with, or my this carrier up with, tied around a tree, and use a toggle to hang it up with. Or it's a short enough piece that I can use it to set up a plow point configuration. That way I don't have to cut anything. All right, sorry, I'm really doing my best to wait for these airplanes to pass by so you're not constantly hearing them, but it's a busy day for air traffic. Then I have two small pieces of paracord that I can use to tie prussic knots. So I've got everything already like cut and lengthened out to where I don't have to try to do all that while I'm out, you know, hiking or whatever, if I'm ever gonna need it. Then I've got a bandana, a clean one, and it actually happens to be one of those ones with all the survival stuff on it, so that would give me something to read if I got bored. Then I have another convenient item, something to sharpen and hone my knife up with. It's just a Lansky mini dog bone sharpener. It doesn't weigh anything and it fits in this pocket perfect, so might as well bring it and put it in there. Then I have a backup lighter. I've already got one in my pocket, so that's two lighters right there. And then a small little roll of Gorilla tape. Then in this pocket over here on this side, I don't have much. I have my actual measured out ridge line, and this is about 30-35 feet of paracord. Really, like back to back, it's just ridiculous, unbelievable. And then underneath the paracord bundle, I have a Dragonfire Tinderbox Fireball. So just a surefire method. You probably noticed I don't have a ferro rod in this kit. Well, it's because I've got a ferro rod in my pocket at all times. That's my EDC. And then I also, if I have my belt knife on, I have a ferro rod with my belt knife. So that's two ferro rods right there. The knife that I'm carrying today is the LT Wright Native Survival Knife that Mitch Mitchell designed. And then I just have one of their, one of LT's hand-turned lanyard beads on here. And then the fire steel that's with it is a somewhat matching fire steel, but this is an LT Wright fire steel I've had for a while, orange liners, and then I've just got green piece of shock cord on there. And then inside the canteen kit itself, I also have my canteen. This is full of water. I have my cup, and then I put the lid underneath the cup and a scotch pad. And the reason why I do that is because I put my Firebox Nano stove in the lid pocket. You just kind of have to kind of pack it to where you put the stove in there first before you pack the other stuff in, and I'll give you enough room. And that's why I have that pocket bellows, is because I've got a little stove. It's small, it's discreet. I can really control the temperature of what I'm cooking with in the titanium, and it's just really functional for me. I really like it. All right, so I just wanted to do my best to go over what my idea of a survival kit would be, and then just show you how I have that mother carrier and G-roll set up to go with each other. I kind of had some back and forth between putting this video out, because I've had it planned for a few weeks now, but I've just constantly been tweaking, adding stuff to that and taking stuff off. And I've kind of put, you know, I put a picture up on my Instagram showing what I was carrying, and just realized, you know, carrying a full-blown 10x7 AquaQuest tarp and all this other stuff, it would make life really easy. But, you know, I'm kind of turning it into camping then. I'm not turning it into, you know, oh crap, I need something to help me out here, I'm in a bad situation. I did forget to include, besides my belt knife and ferro rod and my lighter and my ferro rod in my pocket, that whole kit, the full of water, I haven't taken a sip of water out of it when I weighed it. It's 8.8 pounds for all that stuff. But what I do know is that what's in that kit is more than enough. With practicing and some skill, you can get by with it. And that's what I've kind of come to accept. I know I fight it. I really do. I fight not wanting to carry more, but that's what I've come up with. So thanks for joining me today. Thanks for watching and supporting my channel. I really appreciate all the comments. I wanted to make a quick comment here about the giveaway stuff. Two things. One, I'm very sorry that I'm not responding to any of your comments. I know some of them are personal. You'll tell me what you want to use the tarp for, or what you want to use combustion for, or whatever, and then you make it personal. And if I respond, when I run the random comment generator, it's casting my comments in the lot too. So, and I tried that out with the first giveaway video after I did it. We got lucky, and when I ran the random comment generator, it gave me somebody. Well, then after, you know, I replied to all these comments, I did it again, and, you know, I was winning some of my comments. Like, some of my comments are coming up in a random number generator. So I'm holding off commenting on any of the giveaway videos until after they're done. So I wanted to let you know I'm not ignoring you. And along the same lines, I'm not trying to be mean about it. I'm just trying to be fair. Please only limit one comment per video. So there's been some people that say I'm in, and then they'll do another separate comment saying what they'd use it for. And that's throwing the odds out of whack, because that's giving you two comments for the random generator. So luckily I haven't had to run into that yet. I haven't had that issue, but it just kind of hit me that could be an issue. So if you could just please leave one whole comment. You can type as much as you want. I promise after the giveaway's done, I'm going to go back and respond to it. So I wanted to throw it out there real quick. Thank you for watching this video. Let me know in the comment section any kind of feedback or anything that you might add or subtract from what I have. It's all going to be different based on our areas. So it's really interesting to see what more or less people would do based on where they are. So thanks for watching, everybody. Remember to get outdoors and enjoy the woods.